is a featherweight championship fight between Conor McGregor and Darren Elkins. So here he is, the number one featherweight contender. For a long time, this man believed he was the number one 145-pound fighter on the world. He's called out the champion for a long time. Now he's got the winning streak, the finishes to position himself for the title shot. We will see what he can do with it.
As he steps towards this cage, he understands this is one of the biggest moments in his life, the biggest moment in his career. He is looking to take this title, and he believes his time is now. His preparation has gone perfectly. He is in outstanding shape. He has a great game plan and a great camp, and he believes that he will emerge the new champion of the world tonight after this fight.
Well, Joe Rogan, this man has goals well beyond being the UFC featherweight champion of the world. That is the title that accompanies him as he makes the walk here tonight. He has won this belt. He has defended it in the past. But he wants to be the greatest featherweight of all time. And to do that, you need more title defenses, more dominant performances, more finishes. He wants to be mentioned with the Hall of Fame types. In order to do that tonight, absolutely one he's got to have.
Conor McGregor has that it factor, along with a fantastic and creative striking game, a very good ground game, and extreme confidence in himself. All these make for a fan favorite combination.
Tale of the tape for this featherweight championship fight. Elkins is 4 years the elder. McGregor will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And now for the official introductions, we go inside the octagon where we find the venerable Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out United Center in Chicago, Illinois. It's time! Third round for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a freestyle fighter holding a professional record of 24 wins, 7 losses. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Portage, Indiana, USA, presenting the challenger, Darren the Damage Elkins. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 21 wins, 4 losses.
He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Dublin, Ireland, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world, the
This is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners.
I am very fired up for this fight. It's been a long time coming. The fans have been anticipating this for a long time, and it is gonna go down right now.
Let's go. Scheduled for 5 rounds if need be.
Good shots by the champion. Wham! The right and the left behind it. Tags him. Doing an excellent job of mixing up his strikes here.
Effective punch there by Conor.
single attempt.
There's the single.
He postures into place. Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy.
Switching stances here.
He just whips that punch in.
Nice combination of strikes there by McGregor.
Nicely done.
McGregor gets back up again.
That one hurt.
Tags him with the uppercut. Well, he's playing with fire here, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable to that jab by almost leaning into it right into his opponent's range. Gotta find a way to move those feet and ultimately get that head off of the center line. And he lands a nice kick.
Oh, he is landing those leg kicks over and over again.
Leg kick checked by Darren Elkins.
Beautiful right leg kick there.
Able to land with the left hand.
Another nasty leg kick by Connor.
Oh, and how about it? He takes the fight to the ground one more time. You know that was his game plan coming in. Exactly what he planned on doing here on fight night. And really, Joe, he has taken him down at will.
Hard hook.
Oh, and he lands another punch. Well, he's always on the counterattack, but a nice leg kick there by Connor.
He hit him with the hook. Lands a nice kick. Another hard leg kick by Connor.
Takedown attempt late in the round, and he gets it.
Back up to his feet again.
Oh, and he tags him with the straight. Beautifully placed there by Elkins.
Here's a perfect kick to the body. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. Here's a powerful head kick that lands. Lots of action in that round.
Slow it down, get some water. Listen, everything you're putting out there is working. Want you to stay.
Brittany Pop. All right, let's get to round two.
This is gonna become one of those things where you're just wondering what's the opponent gonna be able to do to him. Not even whether or not he's gonna win, but what's his opponent gonna be able to do to him?
Able to land to the body there with the left kick.
Another vicious kick from McGregor.
Well, no doubt about it, these leg kicks have been money all night. Can we show you the total strikes? Visibly limping here. Well, the offense has been there. He is landing some good shots, but not really stringing them together and putting combinations on his opponent. He's got to mix up his strikes, change his tempo a little bit, and try to get his opponent out of there by landing more than just one strike at a time. And busy as he looks to improve position here. Both fighters get up now. Lead kick is true there by McGregor.
Nice shot.
3 minutes remain in the round. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position.
Elkins gets in the clinch. And he landed the right hand there. Elkins gets double underhooks here in the clinch. Normally now he'll try to change levels and go for a takedown. under 2 minutes now to go in round two.
They separate from the clinch.
Well, the kick lands to the head there, Joe, but I gotta say, he moved right into it. So let's see if he can make the adjustments, try to circle out, and at the very least get that guard up. Not a good look for him here.
Whenever you see a fighter's legs stiffen up like that, that's not a good sign.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground, staying busy.
And back up again.
Changes his stance. With conviction to the body. Look for him to try to set up another takedown here. Elkins' attempt there is blocked by the opponent.
And there it is again.
Takedown attempt late, and it's good.
And he's back up again. He's orthodox now.
Elkins gets tagged by the kick there. He couldn't have liked that too much, Joe. And that's the end of round number two. So mercifully, the round comes to an end. Multiple knockdowns there, maybe a 10-8, maybe even a 10-7. Huge round from McGregor.
A huge round. His opponent was in deep, deep water, but through conditioning and willpower, managed to make it out alive. Here's a devastating kick that results in a knockdown.
Kicks up a little bit better.
Ariane Celeste.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Go. Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient.
Whoa! This could be it. He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. Perfectly timed sweep. He gets the full mount. He's on top, on the back. Excellent movement here on the ground.
Engaging in the clinch here once again. And some nice defensive work being put in by Darren Elkins. Takedown attempt there. McGregor gets the single leg takedown.
Just tagged him with the right hand there.
Oh, so an interesting decision there as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position. Well, you didn't see a lot of the body work from him in the earlier rounds, but he's certainly getting after it here. Big shot to the body connects there. We'll see if he can follow it up.
In half guard position.
Back to the feet now. There's the leg kick. That one checked by Elkins. Postures up here and now going to the body with that big strike. Nicely done by Darren Elkins.
He's back up to his feet.
His leg appears to be hurt here, Joe. That is an obvious leg. Well, he works hard to get up again here, but he looks hurt. And he connects with the punch.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Well, Joe, I know he respects the power coming back, but it looked like he moved right into that kick.
Vicious leg kick lands. He is not going to be able to continue. That's it. It's over. Over and over again, Connor was able to land these devastating leg kicks, and his opponent could only take so much.
Yeah, Joe, you're right. It was that one big strike that started it all to drop his opponent and then ultimately create a further opening to jump in and force the referee stoppage. So a flurry at the end of this fight and a big TKO victory for that young man here tonight.
Let's see it one more time.
Well, it's hard to do much better than that on the biggest of stages, Joe. There he is, the UFC featherweight champion of the world. Your winner tonight by TKO. Bruce Buffer has
Ladies
your official decision.
Dan Mariotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 42 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by TKO, and still the undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world, the notorious Conor McGregor.
Well, no surprise, they are all still chasing this man at 145 pounds. He is the UFC featherweight champion. That's the way he came in. And after the TKO win tonight, that is exactly the way he goes out. He was confident coming in that he would get the finish, and it materialized pretty quickly here tonight.